Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank, a locally owned community bank providing a full range of banking services. At Genoa Bank, we believe a bank should do more than just conduct business. We genuinely care about the communities we serve, and we take our hometown commitment to heart. Our biggest investment will always be in you, whether it's a personal account or business. Genoa Bank is committed to outstanding service. We want to know you by name and help you with all your banking needs. Genoa Bank, we take your banking needs personally.
I can tell love is everywhere.
Thank you. Pero en el sur se va a ir a la casa de contra.
Thank you.
dream. That's where I know you'll always be.
Greymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamide Lime and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Greymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.greymont.com.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Furnace not working? Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing can help. Go to wojosheating.com.
Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jameson's Mobile Music and Video. If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, D'Estasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike D'Estasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. D'Estasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank, a locally owned community bank providing a full range of banking services. At Genoa Bank, we believe a bank should do more than just conduct business. We genuinely care about the communities we serve, and we take our hometown commitment to heart. Our biggest investment will always be in you, whether it's a personal account or business. Genoa Bank is committed to outstanding service. We want to know you by name and help you with all your banking needs. Genoa Bank, we take your banking needs personally.
I can't tell, love is everywhere.
Greymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamide Lime and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Greymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.greymont.com.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Furnace not working? Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing can help. Go to wojosheating.com.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video. If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, D'Estasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike D'Estasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. D'Estasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
All my days in a dream. That's swear I know you'll always be.
Greymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamide Lime and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Greymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.greymont.com.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Furnace not working? Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing can help. Go to wojosheating.com.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
Single nights at our Lake Flyers. These high schools are members of the Ohio High School Athletic Association and abide by the rules and regulations as set forth by the association to maintain high standards of conduct, competition, and relations with member schools. These are high school athletes playing here tonight as friendly rivals of opposing teams. An attitude of good sportsmanship should be reflected by the student body, parents, and spectators towards the athletes and officials involved in this contest. Your cooperation in promoting good sportsmanship is expected. In addition, please use the hallways behind the end bleachers to cross the floor during the contest. We live in a great country with freedoms like no other. To honor America and in respect for all who have served this great country to defend these freedoms, please rise for the playing of our national anthem. The officials assigned to this game have been selected and assigned according to procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Let's welcome tonight's officials, Sean Glass, Ed Kalanko, and Rod Wads. Now, introducing the starters for the visitors from Otsego, 5'4" senior, number 14, Madeline Berry. 5'8" sophomore, number 3, Lauren Hilsheim. 5'8" sophomore, number 4, Cameron Holler. 5'7" senior, number 2, Heidi Kreslowski. and a 6 foot senior, number 10, Ellie Roger Roberts. The Knights are coached by Eric Simon. And now introducing the starters for our Lake Flyers. A 5 foot 10 inch junior, number 2, Ava Ayers. A 5 foot 11 inch senior, number 10, is Haley St. John. 5 foot 5 inch junior, number 11, Kelsey Gladio. 5 foot 11 inch junior, number 14, Bridget Enright. And a 5 foot 10 inch junior, number 20, Delaney Robinson. The Flyers are coached by Joe Noah. Enjoy the game.
And we're here at Lake High School for the NBC Showdown, and I call it a showdown. This is Pat Eakin with Dave Cheatham, and we have Jay at the, what's Jay's last name?
Williams.
Jay Williams, I'm sorry.
There we go, my mic's on now.
I've known Jay forever, but I don't think I ever knew his last name. So it's Lake and Otsego. The Flyers are 4-1, and the Knights are 2-0. Flyers are 3-1, excuse me. They have wins over Swanton, Rossford, and Lake. Picked to win the NBC. They lost to Bryan, the Northwest Wildlife League preseason or defending champions, co-champions. And the Otsego Knights have defeated Rossford and Evergreen. And we're right off the bat here. And Avery Ayers gets a rebound on a miss inside. And the Flyers looking to score, and it's stolen. So the Knights undefeated. They have won 3 of the last 6. Stolen again the other way by the Flyers, trying to get the trying to score in transition, but going virtually not getting to the rim. So the Flyers will set up in their half-court offense. Flyers are led here on senior night by their only senior, and look at that, going right to the rim. Yeah, I was just getting ready to talk about her, Haley St. John. A 5'11 senior. She's the only senior on the team, even though they are the preseason favorites to win this league. And they, she will be heading to Lawrence University, NIA school, to play basketball next year. And they honored her and the Otsego seniors tonight. And she was puts Lake up 2-0. And they're doing some trapping at the end of the floor and getting another turnover for the Flyers.
That was great defense there by Lake. They swarmed her and had nowhere to go. And
yeah, St. John and Kelsey Gladio on the successful trap. And there's Ava Ayers. Oh, she's charged for the player control foul. Ed Colanco makes a call there.
That foul is on number 2, Ava Ayers.
The Walbridge mayor here doing the game. I wonder if he was on call tonight because he came in to, at the last moment to fill in the JV game. They only had one official at the start, and a varsity official. He did a good job in the JV game. The Lake JVs won 51-13, but Otsego had 3 players missing, I assume because of COVID protocol, and not here tonight is one senior, one key senior, Paige Varner, who would be starting, a 5'8 senior guard, senior wing. So Paige is not here. The Flyers are led by Madeline Berry, Heidi Przoski, Lauren Hilsheim, and Cameron Holler are your starters. Berry's the only one coming in the season with any real varsity experience. The Flyers graduate Bryn Lines, who scored 10.8 points, and Hannah Schmoyer, the daughter of the late Dwayne Schmoyer. Both of them were all NBC picks. Hannah averaged 10.4 rebounds a game, and they were 21-4 and 13-1 in the NBC last year, but their last game they played was against Lake in the district tournament, which Lake won that game after losing twice to the Knights during the season. So Otsego probably comes out with a little bit feeling like to avenge that loss, but unfortunately they've got almost a brand new team this year. Only three Letterman back. And hitting the three for the Flyers, baseline.
Another steal.
It's Delaney Robinson. She does that well, and another steal. Delaney can shoot. You got, boy, I tell you, she scored over 30 points in a game in the tournament. A lot of them from long range. She's an amazing shooter. So we're Otsego calls a timeout. We're not even 2 minutes in this game, and the Flyers are up 5-0. So we'll take a break right after, and we'll be back right after this message.
Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank, a locally owned community bank providing a full range of banking services. At Genoa Bank, we believe a bank should do more than just conduct business. We generally care about the communities we serve, and we take our hometown commitment to heart. Our biggest investment will always be in you, whether it's a personal account or business. Genoa Bank is committed to outstanding service. We want to know you by name and help you with all your banking needs. Genoa Bank, we take your banking needs personally.
So we're back at Lake and see if Siegel can change the tune of this game at all, at least from the start. The Flyers came out hot and their defense all over, and there we go again. Another steal by Robinson, and she scores, and now it's 7-0. So nothing seems to have changed. This is a big night in the NBC. Over at Woodmore, the Eastwood is playing the Wildcats, and we're expecting to hear. There we go again, another steal, another basket for Robinson. She now has 7 already of their 9 points. We're barely 2.5 minutes into this game. There we go again, Robinson leaks out, but this time they call a foul, but it's going against the Knights. And it's already 9-0. We're barely 2.5 minutes into this game. What do you think, Dave?
They do not have an answer right now for this press. Lake is just swarming, and they're all over the place right now and causing havoc right now for Otsego.
Well, like we said, the Knights 2-0, but this is probably their first two big tests. Well, that Woodmore-Eastwood game should be quite a game. I'll contrast the styles over there. That's also being telecast tonight. And there you go. Ava Ayers, baseline three. It's 12-9. 12-0.
Number two, Ava Ayers.
And this is already looking pretty much, and that's going to go out of bounds, but the Knights will hold on to it.
That's a hot corner for them right now. They are just.
Well, they need to stay out of those corners because Lake will continue to trap. A lot of these girls play soccer and they know how to move. And, you know, we got Bridget Enright out there. She's a starter, 5'11 junior. Well, she was the NBC Player of the Year in soccer. She's a goalkeeper. And she was the Alan Miller Jewelers All Press Goalkeeper of the Year for us this year. Just amazing. Competitor. I got to talk to her and her younger sister Mary Enright was a big part of that big JV win, 51-13 in the JV game. So Joe Nowak has his program on the run, and there they go through a weave, and Ayers is going to the basket and getting the rebound, and the Flyers do have height too, so I can see why the coach, and look at Ayers, nice baseline drive, no one there to stop her. 14-0. We're just 3.5 minutes into this game. There's quite a rebound. She's going to be whistled for traveling. Haley St. John, the Lord's commit, coming down there. Give her the credit for the rebound, but also the turnover. Knights go inside. And here's the shot as Enright kind of sways a shot, and Ayers brings it down about as quick as she can inside to St. John, and Haley St. John is going to get a basket and a free throw.
I mean, wow. There's nothing I can say right now. I mean, they are just playing great ball right now, and Otsego is just confused. And
yeah, well, confused, unable to handle it, no doubt. You know, it surprised me when Mike Jameson was telling me about Lake 74-50 win over Woodmore, and just how they, and you know, we in the preseason voting, Lake was only 1 point in the coaches voting ahead of Woodmore. Woodmore was picked second. And Lake sure put an answer to that. It's a long season, though, and I expect to see some things happen in this league before all is said and done. You've also got COVID issues where you got kids quarantined and not showing up. Getting another rebound is St. John. She's just going to go coast to coast.
She's weaving here, weaving back and forth, straight up the middle.
18-0. Wow. 18-0. We're a little over halfway through the first quarter. And Otsego coach Eric Simon, who thought he might be competing for a championship too, he wasn't counting that out. He's going to call a timeout. We'll be back right after this timeout.
I can't tell, love is everywhere.
My So we're also talking about the Woodmore-Eastwood game, which you can also watch at Tool Sports Network. And we're expecting to hear that 6'1 senior post, Brooke Allen, is going to get her 1,000th career point tonight. And her twin brother, Austin, scored 26 points for the Wildcats in a win over Gibsonburg. So there's quite a twin tandem for the Wildcats.
You got 3:30 to play here in the first quarter. Lake on top of Otsego, 18-0.
So Otsego's still trying to get on the board, and Ava Ayers gets a rebound. Boy, she's got someone leaking out there. Lead pass is just a little bit too much. And you know that's going up. And so getting the long rebound there for the Flyers was
foul number 4, Cameron Holland at the line.
Haley St. John, after Delaney Robinson put up the 3, and she goes back up with it. She's going to shoot 2. And St. John gets the first, and she's got 7 points now. Her and Robinson have 7 points each to lead Lake right now. And Ava Ayers has 2, or 5, excuse me. So St. John can get her 8th point there, and she does. Nothing but net. 20-0. That sounds like a football game here. This is just worse. Sounds like the Browns last Sunday. There's the first period. So getting the steal was Kelsey Gladio, who is a player that's missed most of last year because of an injury. Comes off the, she started tonight. And there you go, inbounds pass to St. John. It's 22-0 with just under 3 minutes to go in the first. I don't know what you say about this. I didn't expect it. Now I know Otsego's missing some players tonight. And of course the big one is Paige Varner, but I don't know what it's getting to point of pass, point of no return here eventually. I've seen stranger things. You know, Lake just has 1 senior. Otsego has 5. 15, the 5 seniors for Otsego are honored tonight are Madeline Berry, Avery Sepek, Heidi Brzosley, Ellie Roberts, and Paige Varner. And it's just almost like playing half-court basketball on one end of the court here tonight. Knights have already even had more than just a couple shots because of all the turnovers. So Madeline Berry tries to get some penetration against this man-to-man defense, and they're throwing it around, looking for just for anything, and going to the hoop, and a nice rebound is Avery Sepek, and she can't get back up, and she gets whistled for a 3-second call.
She should have kept it up above her head. You know, you bring that ball
she
down low.
She should just go right back,
you know,
no matter
exactly.
What.
Go straight
and she
up with
got the
it.
Foul.
Yep.
Yeah, she's just standing there, and that's not going
to
work.
And then, unfortunately,
you
one of her teammates
right
was in the...
You need to go right back up, and you'll be shooting, too.
In the middle of the key, standing there, and 3-second violation.
She's got some good height, too. Sepek is 6 foot. Oh, look at that.
Glass.
Look at that. That's Jade Rose. At 5'6", junior, coming into the game.
15,
and now it's 25-0. This is just wild, I'll tell you. Siegel getting, there's another steal. And coming away with it is Elsie Stasek. And boy, they've had to do that a couple times, trying to get down in transition. And lead pass a little bit too much, and Knights come away with it. So Otsego will try to take another opportunity just to get on the board, and there's yet another steal. We're going to have double-digit steals. Well, that's Abby Reimers on that one, and look at that. Going right through two people.
23, Elise Stasek,
and she's on the board tonight, her first 2 points. And it's 27-0, and there's another one. And there you go, leaking out is Robinson. And now it's 29-0. Robinson already has 9 points tonight. And Joe Nowak is 29 to nothing, folks, with 30 seconds to go. I don't know in this day when you got COVID protocols and players missing. There you go, getting on the board finally. For Rod Siegel, getting to the basket is Madeline Berry, the senior guard, 5'4 senior guard. And Robinson, and she's going to get whistled for an offensive player control charge there.
All right, Rod Siegel broke the ice now. So
yeah, well.
Relax.
They got a lot more ice to break. They need to change.
I'm trying to think positive here.
I know. I want to think positive, too, for the Knights. You know, I know the Varner family and the Smoyer family. Merrick, they played in my golf league, both their fathers.
Right.
That you're in of both those girls. And Dwayne did, and so did Paige Varner's father. And he won a championship even. So both of them won a championship in our league. Dwayne won our first with him and Rick Donald. So 29-2 at the end of the first quarter. And we'll be back right after this message.
That's where I know you'll always be.
So we're back at Lake High School. This is a teaching moment for Otsego coach Eric Simon. His Knights down 29-2. They've got a long way to come back, and you know they do have players missing. Their senior wing, Paige Varner, 5'8 senior wing, an athlete, and they could use her right now. So the Knights have their work cut out for them. And inside, and a nice move in the paint, Ellie Roberts, the 6-foot senior post. She was there probably. Their most significant player with playing time going right to the hole is Haley St. John. She now has 12 points, the Lord's University commit. So she's going to make the most out of this season. She'll get to drive up, ride with her team to places like Spring Arbor and Concordia. And so again, another rebound, Ava Ayers, and it's just amazing. You know, she's the playmaker, and she's getting a lot of rebounds. Oh boy! And there you go, an unforced turnover by the Knights. So the Flyers get the ball back with men in the second quarter. It's 31-4. What do you think, Dave? What would you do if you were Rod Siegel coach right now? Or
I just tell them, you know, to slow down. You guys know what you need to do. Just relax, because
yeah.
You know, being in a hurry, you know, unforced error they just had there and throwing the ball away. Just relax, go back to basics. And
well, there's a shutoff. You know, Abby Reimer's trying to get baseline, and they were doing that so easily early in that time. Otsego was able to force a turnover. So that's one improvement. And there's a long three by Lauren Hilsheim. And coming back the other way, and there's another three, and that's off. And here come the Knights, and they're running with the Flyers now. We're on a 94-foot floor here, too, which not many schools in NBC have that. This is a longer floor. College NBA floor here, so link floor. So sometimes that can make a difference. And it actually, you know, you think it'd be less scoring, but a lot of times it leads to more scoring because it opens up the game, it opens up the transition game.
Definitely, it's a lot fast paced now, so game
yeah.
Is definitely a lot faster.
Yeah, it's a little bit different game. It's boy, it's sometimes you see these games on these longer fours, and some of these kids aren't used to it. If they're not playing on it, they, you know, it takes forever for them to get one end to the other. And it's nice to trap on these floors, too.
Mm-hmm.
You trap on these floors, and your other players are, like, way far away that you're trying to reach, and you can really force turnovers on a 90-foot, 4-foot floor. There's a nice defensive swat by the Knights. Cameron Holler, 5'8 sophomore wing. She started tonight.
5:37 here to go until halftime. Your score, the Flyers on top of the Knights right now, 31-4.
There's a nice pass behind the defense, but Flyers turn the ball way over. So we've seen a few turnovers here this quarter. And better defense by Siegel. And Lake's taking off their press, too. So they're going to let their girls rest a little bit, and I'm sure if they need it, they'll put it right back in. So we're probably down to a half-court game now, both ends. Oh, and that's over and back. Swatted away. Followed by Lee Stasek. And the Flyers back in their half-court offense. St. John takes a 12-foot jumper, and she's fouled, so she's 2. She's 12 points tonight.
16 foul there on the Knights. Flyers only have 2 team fouls. 5:04 to go here until halftime.
St. John is off the front of the rim on the first one. So this one will be playable. Coming in for Odd Siegel is Avery Sepak, the 6-foot senior post. Get some height back in the game. And she gets a long rebound off the 2 misses there by St. John. There's a nice shot for 3 points by Heidi Przewski. Avery Ayers with a rebound, tries to score inside. She misses. And coming down with the board is Avery Sepak. So she's in there for good reason. And now we're halfway almost through the second quarter. And Knights are being a little more resilient. The Lakes are just, Flyers have just outscored them 4-3. And they're taking an extra step for the Knights.
Number 14, Bridget Emery.
Is Heidi Przewski. Przewski has not scored tonight. St. John looks at maybe taking the 3. Robinson fakes, goes to the hole, and scores.
Delaney Robinson
now in double figures. So Lake has 2 players in double figures, Robinson and St. John. And there's a swatting away, Kelsey Gladio, and she's going to finish at the other end, 35-7.
Number 11, Kelsey Gladio.
That's her first points tonight, but she has a couple steals. Boy, Otsego doing a lot of dribbling. Just a lot of dribbling. I like to see some passing, some ball movement. And just, you know, being aware and tying up there is Haley St. John. And, you know, you're going up against a future collegiate basketball player.
Right now, I mean, Lake, they're playing defense with their feet. They're moving around and just like that. And on Siegel, they're playing with their hands right now, and they're just getting that first step around them and getting easy baskets.
Lake is so well coached, Joe Nowak. And Eric Simon, he just got a young team, not a lot of varsity experience. It's amazing they were able to start off with a couple wins. Evergreen must be down because they've usually had a pretty good program. We know Toby Ledesma at Rossford, his team is down and struggling to get wins right now. So after graduating some amazing talent last year, especially his star player, she's not playing it and getting playing time at the University of Toledo.
That foul was on Roberts. That's her third.
So Robinson shooting a 1-1. Hits the first, 36-7.
2:51 here to go in the second quarter. I am David. We got Pat and you got Jay on the camera for you.
Well, you know, Jameson and I saw Lake take on Bryan in their opener, and they did look a little raw that night. And I think the way they are now, that could have been a whole different game. They seem to smooth things out. So look at that. Robinson gets a rebound, and that hits St. John on the run, and they've been doing that all night, just scoring in transition. We do have a foul on Lake. Knights will take the ball in their own backcourt.
A foul is on number 20, Dwayne Robinson.
As St. John gets a rebound, she's going to hit Robinson, who's leaking out, and this is almost like cherry picking now, just leaking out and scoring in transition, and nobody's getting back. I could see Ava Ayers putting this one up, but she's not going to. But Delaney Robinson is, and she got it. 40-7. Delaney Robinson has 16 points tonight.
Delaney Robinson, 4-3.
And I guarantee you she'll be playing collegiate ball somewhere too. She's a junior this year. And she, gets that pass, and there's nobody running. So you see that happen, you got to go. As if Lake needs another opportunity, right?
right.
Maybe you just get
I
to
mean,
the point
they are
where just
everywhere right now. They're definitely two steps ahead of every player right there for Rod Siegel.
Yeah. A lot of dribbling. Mm-hmm.
They're not cutting. They need to move
they're
around.
Cutting,
I mean, they're making it
dribbling.
Easy for the defense
just,
right now.
Yeah, they are. They're just dribbling on the perimeter. Lake isn't a man-to-man, but there's nobody going. They're just going sideways. There's a nice pass, so inside to Cameron Holler. Cameron Holler does make a nice cut to the basket and gets behind her defender.
Under a minute to play.
Oh. And blocked. Cameron Holler gets the block there, and now the Knights have a chance to get into double figures before half. 40-9. We're down to 30 seconds. See if they just a lot of dribbling. I just, this is not going to get them anywhere. And with the head down too, they got it. No awareness, and this is just something that has to be learned.
And there's an errant pass, goes out of bounds, another turnover for Rod Siegel. Yeah, right now they just need to relax, and I mean, they're...
Well, yeah, and I think Paige, without Paige Varner here, I told there's up to three players that are not here tonight, so I think they probably even have some players brought from JV for tonight's game.
Now, how do they determine that? Now, who can play and then they're not playing, or if they're going to have somebody
can play.
No, I'm just saying, we'll talk about it when we come back.
Yeah, they all can play. They can play five quarters in the night. So we go into halftime, and Lake leads off the three-point shot by Robinson, 43-9, and Robinson has 19 points. So we'll see you back here for the second half of this Northern Buckeye Conference showdown.
Graymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamite, Lime, and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Furnace not working? Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing can help. Go to wojosheating.com.
Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jameson's Mobile Music and Video. If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, D'Estasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike D'Estasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. D'Estasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank, a locally owned community bank providing a full range of banking services. At Genoa Bank, we believe a bank should do more than just conduct business. We generally care about the communities we serve, and we take our hometown commitment to heart. Our biggest investment will always be in you, whether it's a personal account or business. Genoa Bank is committed to outstanding service. We want to know you by name and help you with all your banking needs. Genoa Bank, we take your banking needs personally.
I can't tell, love is everywhere.
Graymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamite, Lime, and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Hey.
Furnace not working? Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing can help. Go to wojosheating.com.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, D'Estasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike D'Estasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. D'Estasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank, a locally owned community bank providing a full range of banking services. At Genoa Bank, we believe a bank should do more than just conduct business. We genuinely care about the communities we serve and we take our hometown commitment to heart. Our biggest investment will always be in you, whether it's a personal account or business. Genoa Bank is committed to outstanding service. We want to know you by name and help you with all your banking needs. Genoa Bank, we take your banking needs personally.
I can't tell, love is everywhere. Why can't you perfume in my hair? I just feel love is everywhere.
That's where I know you'll always be.
Graymont in Genoa, producers of Doclamite, Lime, and Hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Furnace not working? Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing can help. Go to wojosheating.com.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
So we're back at Lake. Just a couple seconds into the second half. And I had to run up here, so you hear me breathing. I was talking to Randy Varner, Paige Varner's dad, and Scott Grau, photographer here for the Bowling Green Sentinel Tribune, and catching up on some of your normal high school sports gossip, a lot of talk about COVID and everything, a lot of politics and stuff, but I won't repeat any of that, but you all know it, so about to shut down the sports in Lucas County and what all is going on. High school kids getting to play in quarantine and various things happening. We have a little bit of that affecting tonight's game. So going to the basket there is, that was
basketball number 14, Bridget.
That was Haley St. John went to the basket, nice drive, but then misses, and Bridget Enright gets it off the board and puts it back up, and Bridget scores, and she's the first points tonight. So now it's 45-9, and there's another, I guess you'd call it a steal by St. John, although the ball kind of got away. And I apologize, this game is all Lake, and we're probably getting a lot more Lake in the games than Otsego, but I really thought we'd see a better game, and I think Lake just came out ready to go, and there's another steal. Just the defense, Dave, tonight by Lake, just every time down.
You're right, they're swarming, they're all over the place. I mean, they're moving their feet, and
yeah, look at that.
They're just not giving them a chance to even breathe right now.
Yeah, we had Cameron Holler get a steal at the other end and come right back, and she gets the ball swatted away. So just a lot of that going on here tonight, and possession's not lasting their full term, I'd have to say. And there's a nice move, Ellie Roberts, and she's got 4 points tonight. That's a high score for the Knights tonight. It's 45-11, Otsego in double figures. 2 minutes into the second half. And Ava Ayers sends it to St. John, baseline three, and there's a rebound, and over to Bridget Enright, who scores again. 4 points to the night, 47-11. Just nice heads-up rebound by Kelsey Gladio, and then just an over to Enright in the paint. And there's Robinson with the loose ball. I don't know the steals, numbers of steals and turnovers. I'd say the Knights have to be at 30 turnovers already.
Yeah, they're close. I mean, almost every other play. I mean,
right. And I tell you what, two-thirds of those are steals. I mean, you know, more than two-thirds, probably 89% of them. Very few just turnovers. And then Robinson gets fouled coming down to the center, so she'll 2-2. Ooh, that one just kind of stayed on top of the rim. You didn't know which way it was going to go. Robinson, 19 points. And she's missed some free throws. But St. John goes right back up with it. So Haley St. John has 14 points tonight. And those are the two you're going to probably see leading the team in scoring throughout the year. Robinson just came on really strong late in the year last year, and she has not stopped since. And look at that defense. You see that play, Dave? That's just amazing. Bridget Enright, just the instincts and just getting the ball and making things happen. And
right, you can't teach that.
No, you can't. Here comes St. John again. She's going to go. She's just going to add her points. You know, why not? 51-11. Minutes into the half, and already.
She's got 16.
Yeah.
With 4:50 to go here in the third quarter.
And there's another basket in the paint by the night. And that's Heidi Przlowski. And Przlowski has 3 points tonight. Ava Ayers goes to the basket, and she's fouled. Ava last year averaged 8.3 points, 4.4 rebounds, 2.9 steals, 2.2 assists. She just, every part of the game, she impacts. Multi-sport athlete. She hit the first one. She's got 6 points tonight.
And for the Knights, number 22,
Avery Seaver. Those are just excellent shots, front of the rim and over. That's just the way you do it. Sometimes those are more impressive than the kind that just go straight through. And there's another steal. Wow. This time by Elise Stasek. She goes over to St. John and she'll score. St. John now has 18 points. And I can't blame him. I mean, like we said, it's a teaching moment. Boy, you got to teach here. So Coach Simon wants a timeout. So we'll be back right after this message.
If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, D'Estasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike D'Estasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. D'Estasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, president of Genoa Bank, a locally owned community bank providing a full range of banking services. At Genoa Bank, we believe a bank should do more than just conduct business. We genuinely care about the communities we serve and we take our hometown commitment to heart. Our biggest investment will always be in you, whether it's a personal account or business. Genoa Bank is committed to outstanding service. We want to know you by name and help you with all your banking needs. Genoa Bank, we take your banking needs personally.
Well, we're back at Lake High School with the Flyers leading 55-13. I saw that ad for D'Estasio's Pizza. Boy, Mike D'Estasio, longtime basketball coach at Woodmore, Genoa, golf coach in the area. And I tell you how good his pizza is. Just last night, my wife and I were in Little Italy, Cleveland, and we got a couple pizzas from Mama Santos, which is just unbelievable pizza. And I tell you, D'Estasio's Pizza was in Little Italy, Cleveland. My wife and I went to Youngstown on the way back. We had to pick something up in Youngstown. On the way back, we stopped in Little Italy, which is by Case Western Reserve, University Circle, Wade Park area, Cleveland Clinic there. And D'Estasio's Pizza is just, I tell you, there's a flavor and a recipe there. It's just excellent. So Lake comes out of the break, and right away, Elise Stasek, in transition, going the other way, gets fouled. So she will shoot two. These Flyers are just athletic. I can't wait to see the matchup with Eastwood. Elmwood, oh my gosh, they're 4-0, and nobody's gotten, except for Eastwood, in overtime, nobody's gotten close to them. Elmwood's putting up 70, 80 points a game. Rebecca Thrash just scoring all kinds of points. She's just...
She's only a sophomore?
Yes.
That is crazy.
Jameson saw her and I at Eastwood, and she just came out of nowhere and just took over that game. And
one game, she had 40 points or something did.
Yeah, well, that's right. She's going to be a strong candidate for NBC Player of the Year. But, you know, like I said, it's a long, long, long season yet. And getting the ball inside for the Flyer or for the Knights, and it fouled. There's a long rebound off a shot, and you know what? What more could you expect than Haley St. John just going all the way to the other end on this 94-foot floor.
Got 3:12 to play here in the third quarter. She's got 18 points right now, trying to add to it.
Yeah, and Delaney Robinson is 19, so she can even that up here. Hitting one, she's missing her free throws. Her and Robinson both have missed some.
Yeah, they have missed a couple. It would definitely be worse than what it is.
Yeah, Yeah, maybe that's something Joe Nowak still has to talk about, you know. And this is not a team that will miss free throws, I guarantee you, down when we get down the stretch. You know, this 94-foot floor is just, I tell you, it does make a difference. Boy, if I was practicing here, I would hate to have to do conditioning drills on this floor.
Michigan's and the sprints and everything.
We call them Death Valleys. On this floor, it would just be that much longer.
Line drills, line up.
There's 3 seconds. And just turnover after turnover. I doubt whether that Seagull's gotten 20 shots off tonight from the field. 58-13, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. I'm going to go again. Fouled on the floor, but that's a 15 foul.
Well, we got a break here. I'd like to thank some of our sponsors. Genoa Bank, A+, and Estacio's. Thank you guys all. Marty, everyone who supports Toledo Sports Network. We greatly appreciate it.
Oh, there's Ayers with a steal, but she's while she's grabbing the ball, she's going over the half court line. I saw that happen in the JV game too. There ought to be some kind of rule so that you could like steal the ball within 5 feet. I don't know. That would just complicate things even more.
Right.
Because you get that momentum going, you can't stop. Oh. Things popping in and out for Lake on this end. Robinson. We don't have the name for number 30, and they're not even announcing over the PA, so we'll try and get that for you. Not on the roster. She did play in the JV game. And she wasn't listed on the JV roster as number 30 either. So here we go again. Delaney Robinson. She misses the bunny and she gets her own rebound. Misses another one. Going back up. And opportunities lost there. It could be 62-15 instead of 60-15, Dave.
Think positive. Yeah.
Men, they have to go, 60-15. So like I said, for Eric Simon, it has to be a teaching moment. And there we go. It's just like every single pass. And scoring again is Haley St. John. Now she's got 23 points. And Delaney Robinson can't even keep up because she's not in the game right now. She's taking a breather. So that's not right. And there we go again. This time getting the steal.
Under a minute to play here.
Jade Rose. There's a nice little what Jameson would call his so-called Euro step. Ava Ayers, she's just grown since I think last year. Ava Ayers listed at 5'10". I think last year she was 5'7", 5'8", I'm guessing. A big part of their Northern Buckeye Conference championship volleyball team as well.
Yeah, I like seeing these girls that play multi-sports.
Yes, they do. Haley St. John.
Stay in shape all year round. And
Haley St. John, soccer player. Taryn DeWeese, 6-foot freshman. Big part of that JV win. She's also dressed for varsity. I'm sure we'll see in. And Jade Rose gets a 3. No, I guess she was on the yeah. Just a 2, okay. So at least Stasak is gonna at least go try and pick the pocket.
25 seconds here to go in the third quarter.
And this time it's Kelsey Gladio. She tries to convert on the other end, but it gets knocked away.
Great hands by Otsego there, knocking the ball away with 12 seconds to go.
And Ava Ayers knocks down the 3, just a little bit off baseline. She's in double figures now with 10 points. 67-15. There's a long three. That's a little bit short. So at the end of three, it's Lake 67, Otsego 15. We'll head into the fourth quarter of this Northern Buckeye Conference matchup right after this.
I can't tell, love is everywhere.
So we're back at Lake High School, 67-15. Lake just winning huge over that Otsego Knights. That Otsego came into this game 2-0 with wins over Rossford and Evergreen. But tonight it's all Lake. I have to mention that Lake is, or Otsego is without their 5'8 senior wing, Paige Varner. And boy, I'm sure they wish she was here. But Lake is just playing really well. Defense scoring a lot of baskets in transition, taking advantage of this 94-foot floor, no doubt. Just opening that game up in transition and beating Otsego down to the other end just all night. Ayers going to take another three from about the same spot. As there's a long rebound, comes even back into the Otsego court, but Jade Rose comes up with it. Every time there's a loose ball, it's a Lake player that ends up with it. That's these girls' either soccer or volleyball skills, I guess. And that three by Jade Rhodes misses. So Otsego will get another possession coming down this way and see if they can even get a field goal, a shot off, Dave, because that's not even happening.
No. 7:20 to go here. Knights are trailing 67-15. Trying to get something going here just to build positive, you know.
There's another loose ball, but hey, this time Ed Colanco's going to whistle foul against Flyers. So the Knights will inbound under their own basket. And look at that, just anticipation by Elise Stasek. Getting her leg out there to interrupt that pass. And sticking with it and scoring is 6-foot senior post Ellie Roberts. And she now leads Otsego with 6 points tonight. And now you've got a steal on this end by the Knights.
Madeline Berry, number 14.
And Madeline Berry, the 5'4 senior guard, comes up with it. And just like that, a single scored 4 points in a row. Wow. They're on a 4-0 run. So chasing down the long rebound is Jade Rose. Oh, there's like four rebounds in this possession. That's Veda Delventhal, who had a huge game at 16 points. Well, actually it was Sydney Staley, freshman guard, had 16 points in that JV game. And we may seem to see her in this game. She is dressed for varsity as Coach Nowak getting everybody in at this point.
Nice hustle,
that's right. Look at that, just going with it. At
I least mean, look at her, she's all over the place and playing not, like not, they're down by six.
Right,
I mean,
and not giving up on, that's what you need to do. And here they come. The freshman, Cindy Staley, scored 16 points in that game, and then you also have Taryn DeWeese, a 6-foot freshman. And Jesse Materny, a 5'9 sophomore. Big part of that huge JV win that Lake had. There's a nice move to the basket again by Ellie Roberts. Now 8 points tonight. And it's 67-21, just over 5 minutes remaining. So we've got freshmen and sophomores out there for the Flyers. And there's Taryn DeWeese with a rebound, but she can't finish. Here come the Knights again. And with a nice three attempt, she had a step back, took it. It was Madeline Berry, but she misses. Flyers are just under 5 minutes to go in the game. And Veda Delventhal does not hit that one.
I like seeing the underclassmen here getting that play, you know, getting that experience out
right.
here, you know, getting rid of the...
Oh, that's huge. That's
you know,
huge.
The shakiness and the nerves. And
that's huge, yes.
And see what each, you know, the future holds for each school.
They're going to get their five quarters tonight, that's for sure. So Cindy Stanley bringing it down. She just had a big scoring night in the JV game. And there's a steal again by Madeline Berry. And all of a sudden, she's adding to her stats, and she scores in transition. And she's also fouled. And she's at 6 points tonight. Make that seven if she can put this free throw down. 67-23, halfway through the fourth. And Otsego on an 8-0 run, Dave.
Like I said, that's what they just need to do right now, you know, to see what they can do, build off of it. And
that's right.
Go from there. I mean, you got to keep your head up. They're still fighting hard and not quitting. And
they get a 9-0 run. So Stanley and DeWeese, the freshman, and Materny, the sophomore, they're going to. There's another steal, and this time it's Ellie Roberts again. And getting the loose ball was Madeline Berry, and she's gonna. Oh, and here's a steal by Veda Delventhal. She's coming down, she hits over to Stanley. And she's on the board tonight. So Cindy Stanley has 16 points in the JV and now two in the varsity. So give her 18 points in the night.
There
she's in double figures. That's
right. Got her name in the paper.
That's right. Well, yeah. I don't know what day, because a lot of dailies don't print every day anymore. So I don't know when you'll see that.
Number 30 on the basket.
So Otsego on the board again, 69-26. Yeah, look at Ellie Roberts. She's going for the long rebound, putting it back up. And Otsego will be whistled for traveling under the basket. So here come the Flyers again. 69-26 lead, basically their JV team out there. Freshmen and sophomores.
Under three to go here.
There you go. Nothing but net for Jade Rose. She has 8 points tonight. 72-26. 2.5 to go in the fourth in the game.
They've definitely been deadly from the outside tonight.
They have shot well. And nice move by Ellie Roberts, and she's now in double figures with 10 points. 6 foot senior post. And DeWeese misses, and here come the Knights again. Knights have scored 13 points this quarter. Oh, what's going to call a travel? I didn't know. I could have called a foul on either player. Could have called a lot of things on that. There was a lot of crazy stuff going on underneath that. What do you think, Jay? He's shaking his head. He's not going to say.
You got Jay running the camera. I am David Cheatham. You got Pat Eakin. We are the Toledo Sports Network. Once again, if you'd like to thank some of our sponsors, Genoa Bank, A-plus Home Improvement. You got Marty over at Fairway. We appreciate you guys all.
So every seat back hustles for the loose ball rebound to send and then gets hung up, and Otsego will maintain possession. Minute half to go. Looking to get 30 points here tonight with a basket. I hate to see high school teams end up under 30 points. That to me sounds like a high school game from the 30s or 40s. So here comes Lake in transition again. And Cindy Stater is going to take the long one. Oh, and she just misses. Deweese gets a rebound. She doesn't go back up. And shooting the near baseline three, no good. But look at that hustle there by, like you said before, Jade Rose. That's, you know, you've seen Jade Rose and Elise Stasek. They're just out there hustling. No matter what the score is, what's going on, they're hustling.
Oh, yeah. She's playing great on both sides of the ball. She's got 8 points. Got the scrappy D right there to tie the ball up and keep the possession for the Flyers.
And you know what? Taryn DeWeese needs to go up with some of these shots. She's 6 foot tall. She's a freshman, and she gets the ball in the paint, and she just needs to go up with some of these shots. So we're down to 40 seconds. And Otsego with a chance here to get on the board one last time, and knocking the ball away is Cindy Stanley. Freshman guard. She's going to be a player. Give her a couple years. She might be a contributor to this varsity. Backcourt. No backcourt violation there, though. Yeah, this game's, we're down in the final 22 seconds, and so at times here in the last minute, I just think both teams are just kind of saying, hey, just keep that clock going. Just a lot of strange turnovers now. And Taryn DeWeese comes to the loose ball, and she gets it down court to Delventhal. And Veda Delventhal gets on the board. Her first points tonight, 74-28. We're down to 5 seconds. That won't count. That's your final score, 74-28. Lake proves the 4-1 overall. They're 3-0 in the NBC. Maintain their first place spot in the league. And Otsego falls to 2-1. And that is their first league game tonight. So, you know, we'll see. What do you think, Dave? Lake looked really good tonight.
Yes, they did.
Really
they
impressive.
They were clicking on all cylinders there. You know, I tip my hat to Otsego. You know, they played well. You know, don't be discouraged. You know, just go back to the drawing board. You got to, you know, move those feet on the D. There's a couple of things, you know, I tell them what they, you know, done wrong. But other than that, you know, I just tip my hat to them. They kept playing hard the whole game.
And Coach Simon gets Paige Varner back. And who knows, we get back to Tintagony when the two teams meet on Otsego's floor. It could be a different game. So we'll say goodbye from Lake High School. Your final score, Jay Williams, Dave Cheatham, Pat Eakin here, Lake 74, Otsego 28.